Hey guys, Nikhil here from Home Banao. In this video, I am in a brand new apartment which is about to be inspected. What do you mean by home inspection? Stay tuned to find out. This is Venkatesh from Nemmadi who has a lot of stuff, I guess. So Venkatesh, please take me through the process of home inspection. So what do we have here, Venkatesh? Can you take me through?
Yeah, I will show you. These are the instruments what we are using for the inspection. So this is first, this is a mallet, so for the checking the hollow tiles. This is a water bath. If the water is not there in the flat, so we can use this and we can pour the water in balcony and the toilet to check the slope and all. So this is for the pressure gauge, to check the pressure is sufficient for toilets and all. This is a laser pressure,
so okay.
For the check the as per vena. And then this is a plumber to check the alignment of the doors and walls, edges, and relations is there, so we can check it through this.
Okay.
So and then this is a multimeter.
Okay.
This is a fault detector, so it can be usable for the checking the earthings and then the phase line they have connected properly for the phase and neutral lines. This is a moisture meter, so we can check this moisture content of the wall. So it will show some percentage in the moisture content of the wall. This is a flip camera, so we can check it through that area wherever the water has spread and the moisture content was spread in the wall. So it is work on thermographic cam images, it will produce and we can show that moisture content in the wall. This is a test lamp for the check the all the electrical points on the power supply mode, so we can check it through this. This is a straight edge with the spirit level to check the undulation tiles and walls.
Awesome. So what will you be checking first for me, Venkatesh?
I just wanted to make sure that is the power supply and water supply, there is a plan.
Okay.
So I will check it there.
Okay.
This is the main distribution box.
Okay.
So these are the MCBs.
Okay.
So if you want to make sure that power, here is a one trip button will be there.
Okay.
If you press it, it will, the MCB will automatically comes down. It will be automatically off.
Okay.
So that is makes there is a power supply in the flat.
Okay.
So now we have to check that water supply.
Done. So there's power supply, there's water supply. What will you be doing next?
Area okay. Measurement.
Okay.
We have the instrument, the laser measurement.
Okay.
So by that we can check the area measurement. So what the builder has promised.
Okay. So you'll check power supply, water supply, then area. What do you do next?
So I will check all the tiles, each and every tiles.
Yeah.
If the tile was not properly laid, so that mortar is not bond with that tiles, is there any hollow pockets in below the tiles, means it will make some different sounds.
Okay.
So if you put on any weight materials on the particular tiles, wherever it is exactly hollow, so that tile will automatically break. If it comes any dining table, slides will come on the tiles. If the weight is absolutely very high, so
correct.
If it is load is on the tiles, means there is no sand.
So how will a hollow sand tile sound? Can you show me?
Yeah.
So is this fine? All these tiles are fine?
These tiles are fine.
Okay.
So I will show you that, which is the tile is hollow, I will show you. Make the difference
between yes. So that means this tile is hollow.
The tile is hollow. Then it's joined with the marble tiles, so they are not filled properly. You can see there is a lot of gaps there. See from here, they are not that polished.
Okay.
It is not a better fit. It is a marble. No? There has to be the one coat of polishing in the flat.
Okay.
After the everything they've laid, so there has to be polishing. You can see the stains on there.
Correct. Okay.
These things and all, we'll take it in the report.
Okay. So you will be checking this for all the tiles?
Every tiles we will check. So all the tiles we will check.
So what will you be doing next, Venkatesh?
So we have some checklist for each apartment. Each room has some different checklist. So by the checklist, I will go to every point and we will check.
Okay. So what will you be starting with first?
So I will starting with the, I will show you that our app, so where, how it will be. So this is our app.
Okay.
So everything will be assigned in this app. So this is your apartment. So it will come all the rooms here. So by that each rooms have some, you can see the different checklist here. It is their bedroom. So it will have some 97 checklist.
Okay.
So this is a toilet. So it is a 133 checklist. So like that we have the checklist for each rooms.
Okay.
So each room I have to check all the checklists.
So let's start. What are you checking first?
Yeah, I will start from the foil.
Oh, okay.
I was just checking this beading. This is a dado tile here.
Okay.
It should be properly filled. So I'm checking that. You can see here, so they have not filled the gaps.
Okay.
So if any termites and insects will get inside,
okay.
So it will chance to damage the wood.
Okay.
So for this is a door shutters, and so we will check this alignment also.
Okay.
So alignment if they were done properly or not. So then these door functionalities.
Okay.
So the lock is working properly or not.
Okay.
So around this, if it is a ground floor, so there is a lot of chances of termite attacks. So that way we has to be filled that sealant with the sealant, the gap. There is no gap between the floor and
wood
frame.
Correct.
Otherwise the termite will enter inside and it will chances to damage the wood.
Okay.
So and then here you can see this daguerreotype.
Okay.
So they have not laid properly. I will be taking the photos in my app, so it will come in the report, everything.
Okay.
Yeah.
What next?
So we will check these handles, they are fitted properly or not.
Okay.
And then this laminated wood sheet. So these are laminated.
Okay.
So if they are properly laid or not, so those things are
not. How do you check whether it's properly laid or not?
So we can check. So here, usually if you can see here.
Okay.
You can see here, so that there is a gap between these separate. You can see that gap.
Yes.
So that is, it should be chances of increasing that gap. So it will come up, it will be peeled off.
Correct.
So that is also we will take in the app.
Okay.
So and then this is the electrical medication box. You can okay. see these are now, these things are now rusted.
Nice, yes.
There has to be pasted the circuit diagram.
Okay.
So then you can easily trace out. So each room has each MCBs. You can easily trace out which MCBs belongs to which room.
Correct.
So that you can easily trick that button if any maintenance is going on there. So you don't need to be half entire flat.
Correct.
Here it is missing. Huh. So that I will take it in the report.
Okay. So what will you be doing next, Venkatesh?
So I will check the undulations of the board. So
how do you check that?
So have the torch. So by that we can check that undulation. Can see there is some
underage. Oh, okay. So this you'll be checking for the entire house?
Yes, we'll check. Then we will check the whole, the crack tiles.
Okay, that will just be directly visible, I'm guessing.
Yeah, so it is directly visible.
Okay.
So now I'm going to check the cracks. So, see, here is the crack. So there is a checklist for the crack. So I will take it in the top. I will annotate. I will select a small description, so exact description.
Done. What are you checking next?
So I am now checking that painting patches. So the painting they have not done properly or not. Right? So you can see there is a patches here.
Okay.
Same thing. Like I will take the picture. See, so now the civil is complete. Let's move to the window.
Okay.
So in this window, so we will check the functionalities of the window. So this one window is working or not without any making some noise and all. So we will check that. Then this is some mosquito mesh. So it is also like or properly functioning or not. Like that we will check. Is there any damages of the mosquito net? So that is also we will check. Here is some scratches on the glass. Take that. And I will annotate it. So where it is exactly scratched, so that is easily identifiable. You can see here some window is damaged here. You can see there is a window damage here.
Correct.
But they are filled with some temporary material, so it is not a proper way. So there has to be two properly. Here also we should check from the outside. So you can see these gaps are not, they are not filled properly. So if the rainwater comes now, so it will come inside this and it will make some damp here. So it has to be filled properly this one. And then we will check this outside also. For this ceiling frame, what we call, this is in all they fitted properly or not. It is damaged means. So it makes some cooking noise. If it is operating, it will get with rubbed with other shutter. So
correct.
This way they will provide some ceiling frame here. You can see there is some ceiling frame. Here it is damaged.
Correct.
So it will get rubbed and it will make some cricky noise while it is operating.
So now, what will you be checking in the rooms also?
So now, this is a room. Hmm. So we will check all the door frame checklist and all. So is there any door frame is cracked?
Hmm.
So here is some chip off from the door frame. So this is, we will take it in the report.
Okay.
Take the picture and I will annotate so it is itself.
Okay.
So the next note is, and this hinges and all, is they fitted properly or not?
Okay.
The screws are sometimes the screws have missed. So
okay.
They will not fix the proper screws. So once some screws it will be mixed.
Okay.
So all the screws they are fitted here.
Okay.
This is fine. So we will check with this BD. So you can see this is a gap. They are not fixed properly. So there is a gap. So it may be in place. So this is one thing. And then we will check these locks. It is working smoothly. It is working properly or not. It is working. fitted properly, and it, sometimes it is not aligned properly, it will get touches.
But here it is correct.
Here it is correct. So usually we'll check for everything. So here the, nobody will, can be noticeable. So it is there properly, they will not bind usually. So I will check that. If they are not done, then we'll check here also.
Okay, how will you check that?
So you can feel that this is some smooth finishing, you know? Here the not biting is some rough finish we can feel. So
we'll be taking those photos also.
Yeah, we will take those photos.
What next?
We will check these functionalities of the windows and the mosquito net and the shutters.
Correct.
This is the drainer caps. Usually some they will not provide the drainer caps, so these gaps will be visible from the outside. Some insects will come inside. So that's why there has to be provided some cap will be come here. So there has to be provided that one.
Okay.
And then we'll check these functionalities enough. So then here, see here some dents on the window.
Correct.
So these things will capture in the photo. The same thing like outside also we will check. So now here, this is a wooden flooring. So we have to be checked. We can't check the hollowness here. So we will check that bulging is there properly laid or not. So by that, so walking you can feel that some bulging is. Usually it will be more in the corners. And then you can see some stains here, it is some painting stains. So
for electrical, what all will you be checking?
So in the electricals, we have the fault detector to check. So are things and line and phase they properly connected or not. If it is a reverse means, it will get shocked. So that this is the fault detector. So you can plug it here. If the green and red light will come, means everything will be okay. Are thing and phase line neutral is everything will be okay. This is a multimeter.
Next, what else for electrical?
All the light points we will check. So we have the test lamp here. So by that we will check the, all the light points.
This is working, okay. Yeah. Yeah.
And then all the light points are earthing. There has to be earthing. So we can check, how can we check if it is not a socket. So by this method we can check that earthing. You can see once I touch that line and earthing, the trip button has to be get work. It automatically comes down. You can see.
Oh, okay. It got turned off.
It is a proper earthing.
We heard the trip, by the way, guys. Let's check it once.
Yeah. You can see that it's MCB.
Right.
It's get tripped.
Superb. Okay. So you just have to turn this back on.
Yeah.
So the earthing is working there.
Earthing is working.
Okay.
Like that, we will check all the points.
What else will you be checking in electrical?
Yeah, we will check that all the switches is working or not. Like we okay. will check each and every point. It should be work smoothly, and then this fan points have some proper indications. It is also working or not. We will check that all these switches by spirit cycle and with spirit level. So we will check like it is properly laid or not.
Correct.
No alteration of switch.
Correct.
This also we check, and some buttons will be shaky.
So now that we've finished electrical, civil, what comes next?
So we'll check now the plumbing.
Okay. Yeah. So what all will we be checking in the plumbing?
So here we will check all the functionalities of the taps and L faucet and showers.
Okay.
So we will check this, and then it is properly fitted or not. We will check that. This is a wash machine, so it is shaky. So it is they are not fitted properly. Those things. This counter slab, below the counter slabs, there is a support will be there. So that is should be piped, otherwise it will be get rust. So those things we will check. And then this is also sometimes it is shaky, so they are not fitted properly. These things we will check. And then there is the commode, we will check this, if it is properly fitted or not. So we will check by shaking, like it should be not shaky. So that is one thing. And then here we will check this soft closing, otherwise it will get bang on, it will make some hard noise. Those things we will check, and functionalities of this flash. So both the flashes working, and sometimes it is some leakage in the continuous water flow in the commode. We will check those things. We will check this some here some screws. Those things we will check. It gets rusted or like, and then we will check this functionalities. This is also we will check. So this taps, we will check this. And then this you can see this telephone and shower. They are not fitted properly. You can see here some shaky.
Right.
So using the diary so to get chances of fault also that they are fitted properly. And then this shower is also we'll see here. See. we simply keep it so it is, it should be properly fitted. So like that we will check all this, and then we will also check the slope here for the slope.
How do you check the slope?
We have checked with the spirit level. So we have spirit level and we will check. This is a spirit level.
Okay.
So you can hit the spirit level. So we will check according to the standards. What the what should be standard we will check. Yeah, the slope is also good. Sometimes the water will get stagnant on the column. In the straight edge, we can't identify that. By the pouring of water, we have some water bags. We will pour in that. So we will get the exact, know where the water is stagnant. We will give that report. If there is stagnation, we will give that in the report. So this is a pressure gauge. So why that? So we will check the pressure in this. You can see this. This meter will go up. It is a proper sufficient. Sufficient water pressure is there.
What's the sufficient water pressure generally?
So it is pressure should be 2.5 kg per centimeter square. So more than it is
it's good. Okay. What's next after this?
So we will I will check that with the spirit level. So I'll check the slope. So by that we can't get that exact is there any water stagnations. We can't find that. So by this water bag, we have the water bag. So by pouring the water in the dry wet area, so we can get that water wherever the stagnation. So I will show you.
So how long does it take for the water to completely go down the...
So it will take almost 5 to 10 minutes. So after that we will check if the water is still stagnant. So we will take it in the...
Okay. While that is happening, what else?
So and then we will check the fall ceiling also. We have some selfie stick. So by that we will check the fall above the fall ceiling. Is there any incomplete work now? So we will check there.
Okay.
See here some ceiling is damaged here.
Okay.
So those things we will take it in the report. And then is there any leakages or incomplete works and plumbing fittings, plumbing pipelines will be going on there. So is there any proper fixing over there, done or not, like that we will check. So this is a partition door, so here, so this handle, it is touching the dado, so it leads to get damage the glass as well as the dado also. So there has to be provide some plastic bush or to stop the door, so to it's avoid the touches the handle touches the dado. And then here, so this is a window, so these hinges and all get rusted. So and then it makes some noise, so while it is operating, you can see it is very tough to operate. We will check the hollow tiles here also. And then you can see some stains on the floor. So this is the hollow tiles, we have take it in the report. And then we will check the dado also. So it is one of the drains in the utility area. See here. So they just only fix this flow trap. So there has to be sealed around this flow traps. Otherwise the water gets inside that. It will make some damage. So it is one of the toilets. In the toilets, so you can see this is a pedestal wash machine. So this is they not fitted properly. It's completely shaky. You can make some sound. So those things we will check. And then here some, this is a door frame. You can see these cracks. Now we are checking the dampness. So this is a moisture meter. So in this, so we can check the percentage of the moisture content in the walls. It will show in this percentage. And then this is a flip camera, so which is connected to my smartphone. And when it will show the entire area which is a moisture has absorbed. And then this is work on infrared radiation. So you can come here. So I will show this area is get damped here. See, it is showing some high dampness in this wall. See, this is a area, so these are the plumbings they have done here, so maybe some leakages. So this entire area is get damped. So you can see some purple color areas which is covered. This says it will entire areas get damped. So and then we will take this and then we will do the analysis and then it will come with a report. This is a sliding door. So here this lock is properly working or not, and then it should be working smoothly. Those things we will check. I'm in the balcony now. So we will check all the door locks functionalities and then this door is properly working or not. So and then you can any scratches on the glasses and the ceiling felt what they have provided for the smooth operation. It is properly. So we
So we are in the balcony now. So in the balcony sliding door, so we are checking this all the handles, the properly fitted or not, and then we will check the lock functionalities and all. And is the glass here, no? So this glass, any stains and any scratches, you can see here is some stains here. So those things we will check, and this track. So the railings, rail, so what we call that rail tracking is properly fitted or not. So and then it is, you can see this stopper. So this stopper is totally damaged, it is coming out. So then those things we will check, and for the smooth operation, so they provided some sealing felt, rubber gasket usually called sealing felt. So it should be without any damage, properly laid or not, fixed or not. So we will check those things. And then the sealant has to be filled around the door frame and the sliding door frame. So those things we will check, and this lock receiver. So it is also properly fitted or not, we'll check that functionalities of that. And then it is in the proper alignment or not. So those things we will check here. And then drain hole caps, if rainwater get accumulated inside the tank, it should be drained out. So that's why, so there has to be provide some drain hole. So is that drain hole provided or not? If the provided means like there has to be provide some drain hole caps. So it is missing or not, or is there. So those things we will check here. So we will check this railing sending. So it is properly fitted or it is properly welded or not. So those things we will check. And then this glass holders, and then it is also fitted properly or not, any shaky, all those things we will check. And then we will take it in the report. We will check the hollowness here. See, this is hollow. You can make some noise different. These are the hollow tiles. And then you can see there's a joints, and also they have not filled properly. The joint has to be filled. And then see here. So and some of the shade variation of the skirting tiles. You can see here, this the two different tiles here. So that is also we will take it in the report. So we will check the slope now. So there is a flow trap here. So and then I'm checking with the spirit level. So for the general checking, I'm checking here. So for ultimately, is there any water stagnation on the particular tiles? So we will check by the pouring of water. So water has to be drained out. You can see here water is draining. So if the water is stagnated on anywhere, so we will make there, point it out, and we will take it in the report. Now just to pour the water, usually the water gets stagnated on the corner edges. So those things, it will take some time, and then I will take it in the report if there is any water stagnation.
Wow, that was exhaustive. So typically speaking, when you buy a home, it is obviously one of your most important purchases in your life. And the fact that the value will be in lakhs, if not crores, it makes sense to have so many checks. So Nemedi as a company with whom we did this video, they have over 2000 points which they check in every single home to make sure that you get what you have paid for. So do check them out. The link is in the description. If you have any questions regarding the inspection, please ask them in the comment section below and we will definitely answer them. And if you have any technical questions for Nemedi, please put them in the comment section again and we'll reach out to them, and I'm sure someone from their team will respond. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you in our next one. Thank you.